To shortlist the best sunscreens in India, it's important that you and I know very well about the Purito controversy. The Purito sunscreen controversy started very, very innocently over a comment sent by somebody to the Purito skincare. Purito skincare is a Korean brand, very respected and very loved. Somebody sent a question to them asking them that how is it that these filters are able to give the claim of SPF 50% that the sunscreen promises. Plus, how is this formulation giving the sunscreen credentials of P++++? During this time, the entire YouTube community was fluttering and losing their with the sunscreen because it was so aesthetically beautiful. It was great for sensitive skin. It was in fact great for all skin types. James Welch, Hiram, I do not mean to point fingers at them, but I'm just telling you the credibility that was built for the Purito sunscreen. And because we would look up to channels like them for sunscreen, everybody downstream started adopting Purito sunscreen as the best sunscreen in the market. In response to the question sent to them on the website that questioning about the filters and ingredients, Purito released a video showing that in their lab test, the SPF was actually 80%, not even 50% that they claimed on the product. This triggered the founder of InCDecoder. InCDecoder is where all the beauty conversationalists on YouTube go to understand ingredients and understand what the ingredients are doing. The founder took it upon herself and shared the Purito formulation to a lab in France, I think. And there they did in vitro test, which means the formulation was only tested on lab equipments. That lab reported that the SPF was about 18 to 19%, very far cry from even 50% that they claimed, and definitely a very far cry from the 80% results that Purito shared from their internal lab tests. The INSEE founder was suitably surprised and stunned and sent it to another lab asking them to do in vivo test. This test result also came back with the SPF rating of 15 to 10% and definitely nowhere close to 50, forget about the 80. To reconfirm this test, the stunned founder sent the Purito sunscreen to a lab in Germany. The results came back same and the test was again done for in vivo. That means people were tested for it. The founder posted this on her Instagram and the scandal broke out. Purito responded with a statement saying there's a manufacturer that we have licensed for this particular product who's a very trusted manufacturer. Plus there is the KFDA, which is the Korean version of the FDA, which actually approved this particular formulation and this particular manufacturer. So what do we do? Keep in mind, during all this time, there was this huge excitement being created for this sunscreen that's the best sunscreen available. And people were talking about the filters, ingredients, and all the good things. How the filters play with the formulation, the antioxidants, the emollients, and the other filters in the sunscreen is not something that you and I can see ingredient list and judge. We can't do it, right? And this is very perfectly demonstrated by the Purito sunscreen controversy. So let's stop playing around with sunscreens. This is not a cosmetic. It's not a cream you'll use for 1 year and throw away. Every time you're outside with the sunscreen that's not giving you enough protection, you are number one harming your collagen, therefore giving more rise to wrinkles and UV damage, melasma, pigmentation, but also exposing yourself to skin cancer. So, yes, I'm hating a lot on product reviews nowadays because I just feel that it is just not something which is in the expertise level of people like you and I. We don't have labs in our backyard to actually test the formulations, and especially for sunscreens. Sunscreens are tested in a lab where there are spectrophotometer, which is equipment which actually studies the radiation coming in and how the formulation is able to deflect the radiation and protect your skin. That's not something you and I can do. And with that, here is my take on the few sunscreens that you requested for me to review. Number one, it is not in my purview of expertise to review any sunscreen on earth, but I tried. So the first product that took over was the Bello Photostable Emulgel. I contacted the company because I wanted results. I wanted to see how this sunscreen was certified. Sun Pharmaceuticals is a $1 billion company and it's present in 4 countries, but they're not a customer front company. They produce the product, is given to wholesalers, wholesalers position it to doctors, and doctors give it to patients. I contacted dermatologists and asked them how are they positioning sunscreen. And the response was fairly not shocking because nobody knows. The dermatologist response is here. I obviously can't name who the dermatologist is, but this was a general review of the few dermatologists I met and spoke to. I personally wrote to Sun Pharmaceuticals asking them for details and never heard back. Then I gave them a call. I have the call recording with me, but I'm not sure whether it's legal for me to share that call recording. But it was very pleasant call. They were very nice. I was promised someone was going to call me back. It's been almost 16, 17 days. I haven't heard back and I doubt I will. So for Bello, whatever its claim to fame is, for me, it's not a sunscreen that I'm going to advise anybody. Definitely not a sunscreen I'm going to put on my face. The second request was to review Biore sunscreen. Now, if you look at just the ingredients and everything else, which we all innocently, which we all sillily do, it seems like a great sunscreen. But who has certified it? We don't know. I don't understand the Japanese certification method at all. So till the time it doesn't carry a certification from the FDA or from the COPLA or from the Bootstar method, I can't say it's a great sunscreen. And hell, whether it applies great on my face or doesn't apply on my face is not a point of conversation at all, because it could look like beautiful $1 million sunscreen on my face but still burn me. So what is the point? I have no idea whether this is the right product which is going to give you the right protection that your skin deserves. Then comes Jovees, the innocent little sunscreen which nobody's heard of because it's not a very Instagrammable, YouTubeable product, right? And then there's also Kaya, which a lot of people don't talk about because it's a multi-dollar corporation and they are like, you know, kaun iske bare mein baat karega? Plus, if a YouTuber talking about Kaya, they're not going to get any hits on their YouTube video because uska SEO is very, very high on the list. Nobody going to look at you, you know? So you have to talk about the hot products that are actually there, everybody's talking about, and iska SEO itna high nahi hota hai, so you get more hits on your YouTube. But in a proper study that was done, Jovees was considered to be a very photostable sunscreen. That is a sunscreen I want to put my money on. I want to put my money on the Kaya sunscreen because it's got Boots 5 stars, nothing less, which means it's going to give you protection. And that is the only thing you need from your sunscreen. And if you used Kaya sunscreen, it goes on beautifully, it moisturizes beautifully. For me personally, I only use La Roche-Posay because it gives me tremendous certified protection from sun, especially when I'm outside. I don't care about the, you know, the cast, because that's the least of my requirements. I want that my skin should not wrinkle and shouldn't pigment post my activities outside. That's the most critical thing, right? It does that for me. Neutrogena is again certified, so I use it. And the same thing with Kaya certified, I use it. I did start using Reequil because back then I'd never investigated what really goes into certifying a product. I have requested for information. If it comes in, I'm going to be doing a more detailed review on the Reequil sunscreen. I really like the aesthetics of it and I kind of trust the company's ethics, but I will come back with you for the Reequil sunscreen. In a nutshell, please look for certification if you're really in the game of protecting your skin. So yes, the Beautiful sunscreen had just two filters and a whole lot of great ingredients in it, and that is what got the INSEE founder to kind of question the certification that, or the protection that the sunscreen was claiming it had. But everywhere else on the beauty landscape of YouTube, where everybody was doing product reviews, everybody was appreciating the product, had high praise for the product based on the filters and based on the aesthetics of the sunscreen. Which really brings to light two things that nobody really understands ingredients till you have studied formulation. And this is especially true when it comes to sunscreen. It might check all the boxes in terms of filters, you know, tinasorb hai, avobenzone hai, oxybenzone today is a very trusted filter. It's no longer the bad filter. It might have all of that, but we don't know how the rest of the formulation is interacting with those filters. Is it diluting the SPF protection or is it enhancing the SPF protection? And that can only be seen in test labs which are built to do just that. Test the SPF claim of a product. I'll meet you in the comment section.